This is my laser cutter. And one of the things that I added was a temperature sensor. It needs to be swapped out. And this guy here as well, just doesn't operate in the right temperature range, something I figured out after I bought the sensor. So we're gonna fix this thing and swap it out with something
that just works and functions better and gives us more useful information.
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Did you know my sponsor, PCBWay, offers printed circuit board assembly services? That's right. Right now, it's only $30 for 20 PCBs, plus component sourcing. Online quoting is also available, and they currently have about a 3 to 5 day turnaround time on orders. Big or small, click the link in the description to get your next project started. PCBWay can help.
Now, the temperature sensor, in theory, monitors the water temperature after it leaves the laser. I don't use this machine enough to really warrant even having this, but I do anticipate maybe running jobs where the laser would run all day long. So I think being able to monitor the temperature of your laser is a good thing. And I've chosen to do this using a car temperature sensor system. It runs on 12 volts, and this machine does not run on 12 volts. I bought a power supply. The power supply doesn't work. I'm going to show you that. It needs to be swapped out. Anyway, we're going to fix this thing.
Here's the current 12 volt power supply piece of junk that I bought on eBay. You can see it causes the gauge backlight to flash on and off, so it's not producing a consistent 12 volts of power. Let's remove it and take it out of the machine. Here's the gauge that I removed, and 40C is like 104 Fahrenheit. So I neglected to notice that when I bought the system, and we're gonna put in this Harley Davidson motorcycle gauge, which goes from 0 to 120 F, which is like regular temperature. It's actually gonna be useful. Let's remove the existing power supply, and then I bought an eBay 12 volt 5 amp power supply that we're gonna put inside of here. Let's cut the cable, splice on some leads, and thank you so much to Kato. They supplied me with an exhaust fan and some other equipment for this video. The exhaust fan is fabulous. Let's solder on some XT60 connectors so that we can hook up the power supply and splice that into the existing power 110 volt in the laser itself. All right, now we can just plug in the power supply, all quick disconnect. Let's test the voltage to make sure we get 12 volts, and that's what we have. We can move on. I'm gonna add a little hot glue here just to make sure that we don't have any short circuits in the future. I'm gonna use the existing thermostat that came with the automotive setup and see if that works. Wah, wah, wah. Not gonna work, so barely lifts the needle off the gauge. So let's get a different thermostat. I got one here from another Harley, assuming that that would work.
So
wah wah wah,
the ohm range is wrong. The gauge, we need something that reads between 18 ohms and 322 ohms, right? And luckily this information was here. And so this is what's gonna allow me to finally fix my problem, which is what I should have done in the very beginning. So with nothing hooked up, this is what it reads. It leads together, you'll see the needle will go all the way to the end. All right, I'm gonna take this 110 ohm resistor and we're gonna place it across the gauge. And we'll see what it reads. So that reads just over 20.
If you think being a problem solver is all creativity, well, I got news for you. You're wrong. Mastering your communication skills, conjugation, proper enunciation, and diction, creating sentences in whatever language you speak, is pretty important. And, of course, some basic math skills that you learned along the way are going to be hugely helpful. Ohms are plotted in the x-axis, and both scales of temperature are plotted in the y-axis so you don't screw it up. We know where the 110 ohms lands, so we can see this graph of the thermistor that we need. Let's go over to Mouser and try to find a thermistor with the right characteristics to fit our application. I download the specification sheet from Vishay and try to find the right thermistor for my application. They have several thermistors and they operate in different temperature ranges and different ohm ranges. So finding one that is close to the value of what I need is just a matter of poring over the data. I finally find one and order it. All right, it's arrived. Actually, I ordered two. They were so cheap. So just for you that don't know, a thermistor is a resistor that changes its value based on the temperature. Thus, it's a temperature sensor in our case. Just hook it up to a gauge that can read that change in the ohm value change when the temperature changes, and you got yourself a gauge. So we're going to make ourselves a gauge. Again, thank you to Kato. They sent me their hands-free device here that it's going to allow me to solder everything together. Really like the product, works quite well. That in conjunction with the fume extractor was a huge help in this project. So let's solder up this thermistor, put some lead wires onto it, and we're also going to put some heat shrink tubing around it so that we don't get any shorts. Put the heat gun on it, shrink that tubing, and we're going to encapsulate this in some resin so we don't get oxidation and the sensor lasts for a long time. So this is just a regular modeling clay. This is a straw from a shake, and we're going to fill that straw with some resin and encapsulate the whole thing so it stays together and does not oxidize. Let's put it inside of a cup so we can hold it all stable while we fill everything with resin, so we don't have to mess around with that. Carefully remove the straw, and basically I'm doing this so that I do not have to put the blade against the straw and put any marks on the clear resin. This is the exit tube that comes directly from the laser. You can see it has a hole in it already where the old sensor was. I'll slip the new one in. Oh, too long. So we need to just cut a little bit off of the clear that we cast, and we can slip it back into that tube opening, and when the water passes over it as it comes off the laser, we'll be able to read the temperature. Let's hook it back up, put the lid on our tank, and yes, that's a little bit of antifreeze just to keep everything safe because it does get cold here. Not that cold in my basement, but I'm just trying to be safe. Let's hook up one of these thermistors just to sort of show you how it works out of the box across the lead and what it reads. So just under 80. So probably pretty close to the actual temperature, maybe a little bit higher than it's supposed to be. Due to the additional resistance of the long lead wire, I think the gauge reads a little low, but that's okay.
12 volts right here, and then this is the negative. And so these two leads, the red and the blue, they come straight from the power supply that we added. And then I've just run a jumper to the back here. And this is the light bulb. and this merely provides the backlighting for the gauge. So red just gets jumped here and then the blue. And then I have a jumper coming off of here because I need a negative for the sending and receiving to the thermistor. And then this is the sensing wire right here. So here we'll hook up and it doesn't matter. This way. And so now we have the sensor installed and we just have to mount the gauge and the job is done.
I just want to add that while the gauge does not read 100% temperature accuracy, I'm okay with that. I really just need to monitor the temperature and make sure it's not going up and out of control. So if I have an issue with the machine, I can see what's going on. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.